Yo, what's going on, you guys? Welcome back to my channel, and in today's video I'll be reacting to the official new Thor Love and Thunder trailer. Now everybody, all the fans have been waiting for this trailer to finally drop, and we finally have it. Now I'm gonna be giving my full reaction. I did not see this trailer yet. I woke up this morning on my phone and I saw it on YouTube, but I didn't click on it and I didn't watch it. I waited till this moment right here to give my full reaction to you guys, and so we can all watch it together. Now, without further ado, before we get into the entire reaction video, I would appreciate it if you drop a like, subscribe, and maybe a comment. And if you enjoy this video, subscribe with the post notifications on so you get notified every time I post a new video. Now, without further ado, let's watch this trailer.
These hands were once used for battle.
Okay.
Now they're but humble tools for peace. I need to figure out exactly who I am.
All right, he's getting ripped.
I want to choose my own path. Live in the moment. My superheroing days are over. She's got a smile that it seems to me. Reminds me of childhood
memories. Where everything was as fresh as the bright blue sky. Whoa. Zeus?
I told you. You ever feel lost? Just look into the eyes of the people that you love. Not me.
What the heck?
Just listening.
Yo, it sounds like you like this trailer. It's pretty nice. It's Jane Foster and Mighty Thor. Let's go! My goodness. Let's talk about the trailer right now. Okay, this trailer showed us, like, enough. Like, it didn't show us too much. It didn't show us too little. I feel like it showed us the perfect amount of scenes in the movie that we needed to see. And honestly, at the end of the trailer, I was really hoping to see Gore the God Butcher just like in the shadows, and he's like face like appears out of nowhere and he's like saying something like, "I will kill all gods," or something like that. I was really expecting that, but we didn't get that. But hopefully in the next trailer that Marvel drops, we will get to see Gore the God Butcher. But we will also get to see not too much, because most of Marvel trailers, I feel like it showed us a lot, and it gives a lot of trailers, like Multiverse of Madness. Like, I can already see how the movie's gonna play out. But I am, like, beyond excited for this movie, because we not only are we gonna get Gore the God Butcher, but we're gonna get Jane Foster's Mighty Thor. And I really hope that they, for this Mighty Thor story, they do it good, like, well. Because in the comics, Jane Foster, she had cancer. And after Thor put down Mjolnir, he like gave it up, he didn't want it anymore, the hammer called out to her, and that gave her powers. Thor's magical powers. So I really hope they get that right. I don't know if they're gonna actually have this character or have this version of Jane Foster have cancer. But if they do, that'll be extremely comic accurate, and people learn new things every day. Because I was on TikTok for a little while, and as I'm scrolling, I'm seeing videos and people saying that this image right here is actually a panel from Thor God of Thunder comics. And I did not know that, like, at all. I've never read a Thor comic book, like, at all. And I've also seen that people are saying, like, this monster was killed by Gore the God Butcher. So obviously he's obviously confirmed. He was confirmed from like the beginning of this entire thing of Thor. So yeah, I just learned that, and it's pretty cool because that's like really accurate. Like if Korg wasn't there, that'd be the most accurate shot I've ever seen, because that honestly shocked me. I did not know that at all, and it's really cool how Marvel is incorporating comic images into their movies. Like, that's pretty awesome. So I am just getting more and more hyped for this movie, because we're gonna get Zeus, and Zeus is reminding me of Hercules. So maybe, just maybe, we might get to see Hercules, because if Zeus is there and Olympia, I'm pretty sure that's what it's called, Hercules, it's a high possibility that Hercules might be in this movie, like a little cameo. That would be amazing if he is too. Like, I would love to see a relationship between Hercules and Thor, because I've always wondered, like, if Hercules ever met Thor. Because I've never read Thor comic, but I do have a Marvel encyclopedia, and Hercules is in Marvel, so we must get to see Hercules. And if you do, that's gonna be amazing. And whew, pretty shocking too. Speaking of comic accurate things, a lot of things in this trailer are actually really comic accurate. For example, Mighty Thor's helmet, her costume, that's completely comic accurate. And then at the beginning of the trailer, you could see Thor's like kind of like evolution as Thor when he's a little kid. And I'm pretty sure him as like a teenager, this is him full grown. So this, the teenage version, amazingly comic accurate, the entire helmet and the entire costume, the cape, everything, that's also comic accurate. So yeah, I'm really excited for this movie, and those are really my thoughts on this trailer. And I'm going to be doing a breakdown probably later on today or in a few more days. So be open-minded for that video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.